Good afternoon. Sorry for my English. My name is Apaolaza and I will be present. No? Yeah, maybe? Okay, excuse me. Good afternoon, last time. I'm Xavi and I want to present the thermo-optical performance of solar panel cooker. This study was made by Antonio Carrillo, by Celestino Rubio, by Francisco Serrano, Fernando Dominguez and me. And we come from Málaga University and University of Algarve. I want to present the study. The funnel solar cooker can sample effective and have multiple advantages, like it's easy to do, it's easy to build, it's easy to fold, and also it's low cost, but there are limited data available in scientific literature. This is the reason to choose this kind of solar cooker. And we chose to do a scientific work about it. So the study has two different parts. The first part is the analysis of optical performance, with the presentation of Antonio. The second one is a thermal model. We worked in this, but we don't present it. And the third one is the experimental study, and I want to present it. We have an experimental setup. The setup is a funnel solar cooker. Celestino made this funnel solar cooker, and we have two samples outside. We don't have only one, we have three identical solar cooker, excuse me, with three identical panels and with three identical receiver. The advantage to have three examples is we can do the repeatability test, and we have a lot of results in one test. All panels are rigid, are in aluminum composite panel, and the reflectance of the material is 85%. To avoid the loss in conduction, we put the 8 cm thickness XPS insulator. And on the receiver have two different elements. The first one is the washing machine door glasses, we have two. And the second one is a steel pot with 2.5 liter capacity, and we have the option to put two different covers. The first one is in metal and the other one is in glass. The optical properties of this material is in progress and we want to present another way. The instrumentation of the setup has different parts. We utilize a lot of thermometers. The most are the thermocouples. We have 5. Distributed in the water, we have one in the air but inside the pot, and we have 3 in the pot walls and the other one in the pot cover. We utilize also a local weather station with horizontal global radiation pyrometer with 40 degrees inclination global radiation pyrometer, because the inclination of our cooker is 40 degrees. And we have also an ambient thermometer and an anemometer to measure the wind speed near the kitchen. And we use also a weather station for engineering school to validate the data of the local weather station. To do the experiment, we utilize the standard ASAE S580 protocol or standard, and there are a lot of variables we need to respect in a test, but the most important is the wind average. The insulation will be between 450 watt per square meter and 1,100 watt per square meter in the inclination of the kitchen, and we need also to respect the time to do the test. It will be between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Solar hour. We recorded all parameters in a test, also the temperature and thermometers, and we recorded the data every 15 seconds. In the graph, we can see different curves. It's only for one test. And we can see in the black one is the water temperature, is the average of 5 thermocouples. We have also ambient temperature, is the green one, and we have the free temperature of the pot walls. We recorded also the perimeter radiation. In the graph we can see the perimeter radiation in green, and the perimeter we oriented every 20 minutes, like the kitchen. We turn the kitchen every 20 minutes, and we turn also the pyrometer every 20 minutes to have the same radiation in the kitchen and the pyrometer. And we have the, in red the high level, in blue the low level of the protocol, and we can see also the position of the sun, of the altitude of the sun during the test. Now we have all the data to trade or to watch. And we use also the same standard to trade. The first one we think do is calculate the power in the world. To do this, we use the range for 10 minutes to watch how many power come into the water. And after we establish this power to a standard insulation of 700 watts per square meter. Once we have the two results, we can plot the standard cooking power in function of average temperature difference between water and temperature ambient. And we do a linear regression. If we say a standard test, we can see the first four points are not in linear regression. The reason of this is the solar cooker has an inertia and there are different elements, it's not in temperature also. And the other parameter we see is the single measure of performance. It's a value of the standard cooking power for 50 degrees. It's the one is in purple. Now I want to show the first result. If you watch the left graph, we can see the standard cooking power in function of average temperature for 2 kilograms of water with glass cover. In this graph, there are not only one test, there are 7 different tests. We have in total 49 points, and we do this test with 2 different kitchens. In the red side, we have the same graph, but the difference is we have also 2 kilograms of water, but the difference is the cover is now is metallic. If you watch this graph, we can see from 60 degrees, the regression of the curve is not the same, it's not a spike, we have a deviation. The reason of this, we think there are an important reason. We put a thermocouple in the cover, and we watch the metallic cover is at 200 degrees, and the glass cover is only at 80 degrees. There are a lot of difference between both, and we lose a lot of heat in metallic cover, for the convection, and also we lose a lot of heat because the metallic cover do the radiation in the water and generate the local vaporization in the water surface. But in the glass cover we have a advantage because the water across, no, not the water, the insulation across partially the cover and go to the pot walls, transforming the radiation in head, and the pot walls is in contact with water and the head transmission is better. And we do also different tests. We try the different rises of the receiver. We put the receiver 5 centimeter higher or 7.5 centimeter higher, and we put also different water content in the receiver. We put 2 liters, 2 liters or 2 kilograms, 1.5 kilograms and 1 kilogram. And now I want to show the conclusion. Thermal performance parameters for several configurations of a typical solar panel cooker have been determined following the standard setting. We need a lot of experience in function of the protocol. All resultants are robust and replicable. The configuration with glass cover and elevated receiver is better. The thermal performance is better with high water load. And future work is the characteristics of the product to test different panels, to test different receivers, and we have a lot of work to do. And thank you.
Good. now or once you both finish and then you can have questions. So I suggest you start the second presentation and then we can have questions.
I didn't start. No. Thank you.